Hello, Sarath Gelati from the BRECOflex Applications Engineering Department here with the third and final video in the SM5 Tension Meter series. In this video, I will be covering how to shorten the effective span length of a long belt for a more accurate reading, and how to get a good reading from a short, wide belt. In the second part of this video, I will cover how to calculate the correct belt pretension for a few common belt drives. In this section of the video, I will show you how to measure the pretension of a very long belt. First, use something to block off a section of the belt of a known length, and then take your tension meter and measure the frequency of the shortened belt span. You can use this shortened belt span for the calculation of the tension in terms of newtons. As you can see in this video, it can be very difficult to measure the tension of a short wide belt. To get a better frequency reading on a short wide belt, use something like a screwdriver to apply a sharp force to the edge of the belt to obtain a reading. In this section of the video, I will talk about how to determine the correct pretension for your specific type of belt drive. Select one of the following belt drives and determine the required pretension FV as a function of the peripheral force. These values are a starting point, and tension should be increased as necessary to eliminate sag or flapping during peak peripheral belt loading. The first type of belt drive is a two-pulley drive. For this type of belt drive, if you have less than 60 teeth on the belt, FV is equal to 1/3 of your peripheral force. For 60 to 150 teeth on your belt, FV is equal to 1/2 of the peripheral force. For belts that have greater than 150 teeth, FV is equal to 2/3 of the peripheral force. The next type of belt drive is the linear drive. For any belt span on a linear drive, the pretension FV is equal to the peripheral force. The final type of belt drive that we will discuss is a multiple pulley drive. If the taut length of the belt drive is less than the slack length, FV is equal to the peripheral force. If the taut length is greater than the slack length, FV is greater than the peripheral force. Again, these values are just a starting point, and tension should be increased as necessary to eliminate sag or flapping during peak peripheral belt loading. Be sure not to exceed the maximum allowable pretension of the belt as given by our calculation program. For more information about our SM5 tension meter, please download our engineering bulletin at the link below. To order an SM5 tension meter, please call our customer service department at the number shown at the end of this video. Thanks for watching.